I'm gonna go around this way, even though I know it won't go up the hill. We'll just make it easier later. Give her a bit of a helping hand here. This is really heavy, by the way. I don't think the truck would go up here if it was six-wheel drive, or whatever you want to call it. I'm doing another test is yesterday discovered that there's some interference issues with the airbag suspension, this way it's put together and the way that I build screw drives for my lifts. They were having a conflict, so I had to Mr. Illuminator some of the 3D printed plastic parts and swap some stuff around so that it was a little more to my liking, as well as the fact that like I say, it was required, otherwise this was just gonna continue to be a problem. Anyway, hopefully nobody's offended that I changed their parts. That wasn't my intention. Trying to make two completely different setups cohabitate correctly. So we'll see how it all works out. There's even more dirt in here this time. Just to test the theory out of how durable this is, but I think this I think I'm gonna stand guard on this because the ground's soft on the inside and I do not want it to fall over. I believe it's going to do. That is so close. Sketchy. Slide. This truck is always stacked frozen up. Off, which doesn't help because it's been frozen and it's been raining. It's a pretty good pile of dirt. Like I say, that's over 3 heap shovelfuls. I don't know how heavy that is, but it's heavy. And here you can see one of the parts that was aluminum, or was plastic, I should say. I changed to aluminum on the rear suspension. And I did that so that I could thread it and bolt through it, and then the springs actually hold the suspension now from separating instead of having a bolt that passes all the way through and vibrates back and forth in there. It has a bolt on the top and a bolt on the bottom, a little piece made inside the coil spring for the bottom side to pinch it in there. A bit of screwing around, but I wanted to try and retain as many of the 3D printed parts as I could, so anyway, I think it's gonna work okay. That's enough testing. Take this thing all apart now and clean her up. Get ready for powder coat. We should do that next week. So it can be put back together and gone. And like a new threaded shaft or two, this one's got a slight wobble to it. So not happy with that. Not bad, but yeah, just a slight dirt to it. But I knew that going in, so it's not a surprise. Yeah, I don't have this set up right, or I could just leave the switch on and it would go down on its own, but I don't have it that way because I kind of haywired this together yesterday. I don't have enough hands. I'm not left-handed to begin with. And then trying to drive with two functions at once with my left hand is not a good idea. There we go. This box is down all the way now. Aw, man! So close, eh? We'll give her a boost. Now it goes into second gear. Of course it does. No, they don't want it to. This is a good looking rig anyway, if nothing else. Sweet. Thanks for watching.